Never been to Birmingham, so I'm really looking forward to meeting everybody here and having a laugh with everybody. So far, everybody's been really, really nice, and I'm sure it's going to get even better over the rest of the day and the rest of the weekend. Mainly what it was like working with, say, Dan, Rupert and Emma. How did I blow everything up in the first movie? So they're usually the general question, like what it was like working with individual actors. So we were kind of all just thrown together, and we're lucky that we kind of gelled so quick early on. While filming, I'd have been in a hotel, obviously coming from Ireland, and I was generally with Matthew Lewis, who played Neville, the Phelps twins, which are local lads, and Sean Biggerstaff. So we kind of became really good friends, but on set we all just kind of bonded together and we all became best pals, you know. It was great.
Is there one character in the Potter universe that you most identify with or most enjoy watching?
There's a couple. My favourite would probably be Malfoy. He's a slick-haired git. He's just sleazy, and he's just one of my favourite characters. I always thought there should have been more between Harry and Malfoy throughout the movies. Unfortunately, there wasn't. But, yeah, I like the baddies. I always thought Seamus should be an undercover spy for Slytherin. Oh, yeah. That's what I would have liked, but it didn't happen. But I also love Voldemort. He was really cool. And Snape. So, yeah, all the baddies. The very first day I ever met Alan, nothing ever changed from the very first day till the very last day. He was just always Snape. He was just so scary and intimidating, but at the same time, such a nice guy. The first time I really got to meet Alan Rickman was at the premieres. You know, otherwise I didn't know who Alan was, I just knew Snape. So he was such a fantastic actor that he was able to take on this huge character and then just live as Snape was living. It was crazy to see, you know. You know, my favourite scene with Snape would have been, I think it was maybe the fourth movie, I can't really remember, when we're all in the Great Hall and we're all in our sleeping blankets, and there's Dumbledore and Snape, and they're walking down through while all the kids are asleep, and Alan Rickman had put a fart machine into Daniel's sleeping bag, and I'm sleeping next to Dan. Well, not sleeping next to Dan, but we're in our bags next to each other, and we're halfway through filming this scene, and with that Alan started pressing the button, and it was hilarious to see, like, some two great actors laughing and joking and pulling pranks. It was cool to see. I've seen the new movie and I absolutely loved it. I haven't gone to see the play yet. I did read the book. I was flying off to Australia and I said, I think I was one of the last people to go out and buy this book. But I ended up buying it and read it, and I really, 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 really enjoyed that. And that's the one thing that I want to see, is it live on stage. But the movies have been great. I'm looking forward to seeing the next movie too. There's a couple of different things kind of in the pipeline now at the moment. Hopefully they kind of actually happen and not just fizzle out. I'm busy back home with all the horses and looking after them. We take in a couple of rescue horses every year. We buy and sell horses, and that's kind of my life. Yeah, thanks for all the support over all these years. We started, I think, 2001 or 2017 now, and people are still just as excited to watch the new movies that are coming out, read the new plays, go and see the new plays. So just thanks a million, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the Harry Potter family, all their new movies.